So, in the last class, we have seen about buck converter and boost converter. So, in today's class, we are going to see about the buck boost converter. Okay. In the buck converter, it is a power converting device which will be converting a high value of DC to a low value of DC. Okay. Buck converter, whereas a boost converter, it will convert a low value of DC to high value of DC. So here this buck boost converter, as the name indicates, it is a power converting device. It will be converting either a low value of DC to high value of DC or a high value of DC to low value of DC. It can act as both as buck converter or boost converter. Okay. So as the name suggests, this buck boost converter can be a step up chopper or a step down chopper. Okay. Or it can step up voltage or it can step down voltage. Okay. That is buck boost converter. So it is a device or a power converting device that converts either a low value of DC voltage to a high value of DC voltage or a high value of DC voltage to a low value of DC voltage. Okay. That is buck boost converter. So this is the circuit diagram of a buck boost converter. Here you can see input source is there. To the input source, seriously a switch is connected, then a inductor is there, then a freewheeling diode is here, then capacitor and the load. Okay. So here the inductor will be charging when the switch is on, and the inductor will be discharging when the switch is off. And this freewheeling diode, it will be providing a path for inductor to discharge during when the switch is off. Okay. And the capacitor placed here, the main purpose of this capacitor is to reduce the ripple in the output voltage. Okay. So that is the major purpose of this capacitor. Okay. So here the switch is connected directly to source. So that the source current and the switch current will be equal. Here switch is connected directly to source, so the source current and switch current will be equal. And also inductor will be storing charge when the switch is on, and it will be discharging charge when the switch is off. Correct. Okay. Inductor stores energy during turn on time and turn on off switch, and the it will discharge during the turn off, okay, of the switch. Okay. Capacitor reduces the ripple content in the output voltage, and the freewheeling diode provides discharging path to the inductor when the switch is turned off. Okay. That is what we told here. Okay. So this is the basics about the buck boost converter. Okay. And when the switch is closed at the time is equal to zero, the equivalent circuit will be looking like this. So this is the circuit. When the switch is closed, what will be happening here? Switch is closed. So the inductor will be charging. So here positive is there, this here negative is there. So the diode will be in reverse bias condition, means it will be open circuited. Okay. So the equivalent circuit will be looking like this. Okay. Switch is closed. Inductor will be starts charging due to this input source. And here diode is reverse bias, so it will be open circuited. And you can see here that the source, input source and the output load is having no connection. Okay. Input source and output load is disconnected here. Okay. So here when the switch is closed, the inductor will be charging due to this input source, and the output load is disconnected from the input source because of this diode is reverse biased. As the diode is reverse biased, it will act as an open circuit, so the output load and input source is disconnected. So who will deliver power to this, which element will deliver power to this output load? Here one capacitor is there. Capacitor will be charged already, so this capacitor will be delivering power to the load. Okay. Here source and load is having no connection, so here some load have to be there in the load side. Okay, someone should deliver power to the output. So who will be, which element will be delivering? This capacitor present here, na, it will be already stored, charge will be stored already in the capacitor, so it will be delivering power to the load. Okay, because when the switch is on, the capacitor will be discharging its charge to the load. Okay, so switch will be short circuited and the freewheeling diode will be reverse biased and it will not conduct. So when the switch is on, that is from 0 to DT. Okay, in the last buck converter and boost converter we have seen, when switch is on means time will be from 0 to DT. Okay, T on time. Okay, and the inductor will charge linearly from the input source. Input source is here, inductor will be charging linearly. Okay, from the input source Vs. Also during on condition, the load has to the load will be removed from the source because of this diode is open circuited. Okay, diode is open circuited. So during on condition, capacitor is delivering power to the load. As input source is not connected, the capacitor placed here, it will be delivering power. It will be delivering power to the load, means it will be discharging what all the charges stored in the capacitor, it will be discharging across this load. Okay, during the on time. As the switch is closed and the diode is reverse biased, the inductor will charge from input source. Inductor will charge from input source and it will be charging till this voltage Vs. Okay, so that VL, voltage here, will be equal to Vs. Okay, understood? These are the conditions when switch is on. And when switch is closed, sorry, switch is open or switch is off, the equivalent circuit will be look like here. When the switch is open, you can see the source will be disconnected from this side. Okay, so the equivalent circuit will be looking from this side only. So inductor will be there, this diode will be there, it will be short circuited. Okay, and the inductor will be discharging what all the charge present in the inductor in this direction. Okay, so that the diode will be becoming forward bias and this freewheeling diode will be providing path for this inductor to discharge across this load. Okay, so here inductor will deliver power to the load and the freewheeling diode will become forward bias and provide path to the inductor for discharge. This freewheeling diode, it will be short circuited, means it will be forward bias and it will be providing path to this inductor to discharge the charge present in inductor across this load. Okay, so this is the condition when the switch is off or switch is open. Okay, this will be the equivalent circuit. Okay, and also assume that the inductor current is flowing in this direction. This is just assumption, I will tell about it later. So inductor, let the inductor current is passing as like shown in figure. Okay, okay, and also this is the graph showing that T on time is there, T off time is there, again T on time is there. T on time means 0 to DT and T off time means DT to T. Okay, here this is the inductor current, that inductor current will be charging. Inductor will be charging during on time from IL minimum to IL maximum and inductor will be discharging during off time, that is from IL maximum to IL minimum. Again it will be charging from IL minimum to IL maximum during on time and it will be discharging from IL maximum to IL minimum during off time. Okay, so like that it will be continuing. That is what written here. Your inductor current charges from IL minimum to IL maximum during on time, that is from 0 to DT, and the inductor discharges from IL maximum to IL minimum during off time, off state, that is DT to T. Okay, and now we'll be finding the different parameters as we have seen in buck converter and boost converter. So when the switch is on, when the switch is on, then we have to find the VL on and the IC on. This is the equivalent circuit when the switch is on. So when the switch is on, we have to find VL on and IC on. So applying KCL here in this loop, if we are applying KCL, what will be getting? VL on here inductor, this is inductor, the voltage across the inductor is VL. So VL on, which will be equal to VS, because this is open circuited, no other source is here. So VL on will be equal to VS, that is equation number one, while applying KVL here. And now applying KCL at this node, from the, as this diode is open circuited, here no current will be there. So IC on will be equal to minus of I0, because here incoming current nothing is there, outgoing current means IC on and I0. So IC on plus I0 will be equal to 0, means IC on will be equal to minus of I0. That is equation number 2. Understood na? Here when we are applying KCL in this node, here incoming current is nothing, it is 0, because here it is open circuited, no incoming current is there. Outgoing current means IC on will be here and I0 will be here. Okay, so when we are applying KCL here, IC on plus I0 will be equal to 0, which means IC on will be equal to minus of I0. That is equation number 2. Okay, and second case, when the switch is off, we have to find VL off and IC off. Okay, that is from DT to T when switch is off. Okay, so when the switch is off, equivalent circuit will be looking like this. And in the previously also I have told that, assume that the inductor current is flowing in this direction, so that this diode will be short circuited like that. Okay, so inductor current will be flowing like this. So this will be the IL in this direction, and IC will be coming in this direction. Output current IO will be coming in this direction. Okay, so here applying KVL in the above circuit, when we are applying KVL here in this loop, what will be getting? VL off will be equal to V0, that is VL. VL means plus minus here, and here it is V0. V0 means minus plus. So here VL minus VL off minus V0 will be equal to 0, which means VL off will be equal to V0. That is equation number 3 when we are applying KVL in this loop. Okay, and when we are applying KCL in this node, if you are applying KCL here, incoming current, all are incoming current, right? No outgoing current is there. Here IL is coming in this direction, IC off is coming in this direction, and I0 is coming in this direction, means IL plus IC off plus IO will be equal to 0, which means IC off will be equal to minus of IL plus I0. Understood? When we are applying KCL in this node, IC off will be equal to minus of IL plus I0, which is equation number 4. Okay, so we have got that four equation, 1, 2, 3, 4. And also previously we have seen volt second balance. What volt second balance is stating? That is VL on into T on plus VL off into T off, which will be equal to 0. As we got from 1 and 3, VL on is equal to VS and VL off is equal to V0. So substituting that, and T on is equal to DT and T off is equal to 1 minus D into T. Substituting these all things, we will get VS into DT plus V0 into 1 minus D into T, which will be equal to 0. Solving this as like this, we will get V0 equal to minus D divided by 1 minus D into VS. That is output voltage V0 will be equal to input voltage source into minus D divided by 1 minus D. Here one minus sign is there. Why this minus sign? Here V0 is negative. Why? If the polarity, here we have taken this polarity of V0 as plus minus. This is assumption only. So if we are reversing the polarity of this V0, we will be getting it as positive. That is the only difference here. Okay, if you are reversing, that is here we have put a plus minus. Instead of that, if you have put minus plus, this will be becoming positive. That is the only difference here. And also V0, output voltage is magnitude of output voltage. V0 is D divided by 1 minus D into Vs. Okay, so here you can see by changing the duty cycle. Okay, By changing the duty cycle, we can make it as either step down chopper or a step up chopper. Okay, if d is greater than 0.5, okay, if d is greater than 0.5 means it can act as a step up chopper, or d is less if d is around 0.99, if d is means is 0.99 means you can see 0.99 divided by 1 minus 0.99 means divided by 0.01 means it will be a step up chopper. Okay, if d value is less than 0.5, it will act as a step down chopper. So here, by changing the duty cycle, we can make this as a step up chopper or step down chopper. That is why it got the name buck boost converter. It can boost the input voltage, or the it can reduce the input voltage. So that is V0, which is equal to minus D into 1 minus D into Vs. This minus sign is due to, if we reverse the polarity of this output voltage, it will become plus. Okay, so V0 equal to D divided by 1 minus D into Vs. Okay, that is for buck boost converter. Now similarly, as like a volt second balance, ampere second balance, it states that IC on into T on plus IC off into T off, which will be equal to 0. T on is, we know that it is equal to DT, T off is equal to 1 minus D into T. So taking from 2 and 4, we will be getting IC on and IC off. So substituting everything, we will be getting minus I0 into DT plus minus of IL plus I0 into 1 minus D into T, which will be equal to 0. Solving this, we will be getting IL is equal to minus I0 divided by 1 minus D. Here also 190 sign is there, means the polarity, IL and I0, it will be coming in opposite direction. So this minus sign shows that IL opposite to I0. Okay, so here IL is equal to I0 divided by 1 minus D. Okay, this is the inductor current. Okay, and next one is ripple in inductor current, delta IL. Okay, so from the graph we can see this is the delta IL, means IL max divided IL max minus IL minimum is the delta IL. Okay, delta IL. So we have seen VL on is equal to VS. Okay, from equation number 1, VL on is equal to VS. Okay, VL on we can write it as L into DIL divided by DT. Okay, for inductor, L into DIL by DT. Okay, DIL we can written as delta IL. I have shown in this figure. This is the change in the inductor current, delta IL. This is IL max minus IL minimum. Okay, so DIL can be written as delta IL, and DT for on time, DT is equal to DT, capital DT. Okay, substituting this, we will be getting L into del IL divided by DT, which is equal to VS. So del IL which is equal to D into VS divided by FL, that is 1 by T is equal to F. Okay, substituting that, we will be getting del IL, which will be equal to D into VS divided by FL. This is as same as in boost converter. Okay, so and also IL max we can write from that figure. IL, this is the delta IL. So IL max means we can written as IL average plus delta IL by 2. Okay, IL average plus delta IL by 2 is the IL max. And IL minimum is equal to IL average minus delta IL divided by 2, as same as what we have seen in buck converter and boost converter. And also last one is ripple in capacitor voltage or ripple in output voltage, delta VC or delta V0. Okay, as the switch is closed, the source and load will be disconnected. In the first scenario, as the switch is closed, the source and load will be, as the switch is closed, switch is closed, this source and load will be disconnected. So this capacitor element will be delivering power to this load. Understood? So capacitor, initially it will be charged, and when the switch is on means 0 to DT, this capacitor will be discharging what all the stored charge present in the capacitor, it will be discharging across this load. Okay, so and the capacitor discharges from VC max, it will be having a voltage maximum VC max to VC minimum during the on state, that is from 0 to DT. Here switch is on. Okay, so applying KCL, IC on will be equal to minus of I0. Here IC on will be equal to minus of I0 because no incoming current, only outgoing current is there. So IC on plus I0 will be equal to 0, IC on equal to minus of I0. Okay, and also IC on we can written as C into DVC divided by DT. Here this is the capacitor. So for capacitor IC on we can written as C into DVC divided by DT. Okay. So C into DVC by DT, which will be equal to I0 when we are substituting when IC on in this equation. So C into DVC divided by DT, which is equal to I0. So cross multiplying, we'll be getting DVC, which is equal to I0 divided by C into DT. So integrating both the sides. Integrating both the sides means limit will be IC. IC initially it will be VC max. Sorry, capacitor voltage it will be initially VC max, and after discharging it will be coming to VC minimum. Okay. So capacitor voltage will be coming from, means it will be discharging from VC max to VC minimum. So that will be the limit here, and the for time period. Time period limit is when the switch is on, means 0 to DT. So 0 to DT. So this DVC with the limit V max to V minimum, which will be equal to I0 divided by C into limit 0 to DT DT. Okay. So solving this, we'll be getting delta VC, which will be equal to D into I0 divided by FC, as same as what we have seen in boost converter. So this is the delta VC, ripple in the output voltage. Here also you can see this ripple in the output voltage is directly proportional to the duty cycle. Okay, as same as what we have seen in boost converter. So this is all about the buck boost converter. Buck boost converter is a device, it can convert either a low value of DC to high value of DC, or a high value of DC to low value of DC. That we have seen here, that we can here V0, which is equal to D divided by 1 minus D into Vs, that is based on the duty cycle D. If we are varying the duty cycle, we can make it as a buck converter or a boost converter or a step down chopper or a step up chopper. So this is all about buck boost converter. So hopefully I think all of you understand about this three converters: buck converter, boost converter, buck boost converter. The equations and everything will be same for everything, just only circuit diagram will be having some difference. So based on that we will be taking that equation. So hopefully everyone understood this three types of converter: buck converter, boost converter and buck boost converter. So any doubt, please contact me. Okay.